Hi everyone, welcome to this tutorial on how to get started with the .NET MAUI list view control. Using the list view control, you can present lists of data in a vertical or horizontal orientation with various layouts virtually. In this video, I'll show you how easy it is to add the list view control to your .NET MAUI application and bind data to it. I'll also demonstrate how to select items in the list, change its layout, and add a header and footer. Before you begin, make sure you have installed the latest version of Visual Studio 2022 with the required .NET MAUI workload. You should also have one of the .NET SDKs installed on your machine. Once you have installed the necessary tools, launch Visual Studio 2022 and click Create a New Project from the dashboard. In the Create a New Project window, select the .NET MAUI application from the list of templates and give a project name and location. Here the .NET 7.0 framework is selected by default. I'll proceed with that framework. Click Create to create the project. Now the project is ready. Before I move forward, let's take a quick detour to set up the environment for running our application. Here, I choose an Android emulator. For this demonstration, I will select the Pixel 5 Android emulator. Once the emulator is selected, I'll run the application and show you the default output. The application has started compiling the default code, so let's wait for a few seconds. And now the application's homepage is displayed. Next, I will demonstrate how to incorporate a SyncFusion.NET MAUI list view into this application. I open the NuGet package manager. Search for the SyncFusion MAUI list view package and install it in my application. It will take a few seconds to complete the installation, so let's wait. To proceed with the changes listed in the dialog, click OK. Once the package is installed, I navigate to the main XAML page and remove the default scroll view related code. Then import the SyncFusion MAUI list view namespace and to the local XML namespace, I map the default project namespace, MAUI project. To initialize the list view control, add the SF list view control. Next, I need to register the SyncFusion core handler to map the cross-platform API to the native view API. So, open the MAUI program file and add SyncFusion MAUI core hosting. Then register the handler by adding the configure SyncFusion core method. To use the SyncFusion MAUI controls, it's necessary to register a trial license key. I can do this by opening the AppXAML CS file. Add the register license method and enter the trial license key. To find out where to generate the trial license key, refer to the description below. Now, I will proceed to add data items to the list view to see its basic layout. I am going to bind a list of strings to the list view control, so let me add a class called BookViewModel. Now the class is created, and I change it to public. Then, declare a bindable property, books, of type observable collection of string. And add a constructor for this class. Inside this constructor, I add values for the bindable property. To bind this data object, I open the XAML page and add the binding context property. Access the BookViewModel class here using this local XML namespace. To bind this books collection, I add the item's source property in the SF list view and assign the string collection. Then press the F5 key to run this application. See here, the list view shows the provided data and can be scrolled to view the entire list. Next, I will show you how to bind an object to the list view using an item template property. To demonstrate this, I'm going to use the MVVM pattern to create a collection of objects. First, I create a model class and name it BookInfo. Now the class is created and make it as public. Then, I define the field bookName of the type String. And add another field, BookDescription, with string type. I am going to assign values for these fields. In the ViewModel class, I'll declare another bindable property, BookDetails. Inside this constructor, I will add the required number of data objects to the BookDetails property. In the main XAML page, assign the bindable property name, BookDetails, to the item source property. To display each item in this collection, I add an item template property and a data template to the list view. Here I'm going to display two rows in each list item, one to display the book name and the other one for the description. So, I add the grid control, and using the grid row definitions property, I define two rows with custom heights. Then, add two labels and set the text as book name for the first label and book description to the second label. To the title label, I add the font attribute to bold, text color to cadet blue, and the font size to 21. And for the description, I set the grid row index to 1 and the font size to 15. At last, set the item size property to 94 to customize the item size. Check now, the list items are displayed in two rows. You can also customize the list view by enabling selection, changing the layout, and adding a header and footer. First, I will show you how to perform selection in the list view. By default, you can only select one list view item at a time. I can change the mode by adding the selection mode property. It has four options: multiple, none, single, and single deselect. Here I choose the option, multiple, to select multiple items. See here I can select multiple items. When the selection mode is set to single deselect, I can select one item at a time and also deselect the currently selected item. When the selection mode is set to none, I cannot perform any selections. As you can see, items in the list view are arranged in a single column by default, and this is called a linear layout. You can also customize the layout with a predefined number of columns. For example, I want to arrange the items in two columns. First, I add the items layout property. Inside this layout, I add the grid layout and specify the span count as 2. As I said earlier, this layout will arrange the list of items in two columns, so adjust the list item and change the item size property value to 140. You can see now, the list view is arranged in a grid layout, displaying items in two columns. Finally, I will show you how to add a header and footer using header template and item template properties. To customize the header, I include the header template property and a data template in the list view. To provide the template, I add the grid control with background color and height. Here I'm going to show a single column. So, add a label with text as book list. Also, add the appropriate font attributes, text color, and horizontal and vertical alignment. To customize the footer, copy and paste this template and modify the property name to footer template. In the label, change the text to SyncFusion, all rights reserved. See now, header and footer are added to the list view. Now let me quickly summarize what we have seen so far. I have shown you how to create a .NET MAUI application and add SyncFusion list view control to it. I showed you how to bind data and enable a few of its important features. To learn more about list view features, you can check the documentation link provided in the below description. You can download this working example from the GitHub link in the description below. I've also shared a link where you can see if you're eligible for our community license, giving you a free license key to use our .NET MAUI products. Thank you for watching this video. If you found this video useful, give it a like and subscribe to our channel.